الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. نحمده سبحانه وتعالى حمد الصائمين القائمين الراكعين الساجدين لله وحده. ربنا رب العالمين، ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة، أدى الأمانة، نصح الأمة، كشف الغمة، وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. In these days, my dear brothers and sisters, many brothers and sisters left for the Hajj. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept it from them, and we ask Him سبحانه وتعالى they can return back home safe. But we have to ask ourselves, why these days? What is the Hajj? Why we have to go there? What's our benefits? Why these special days? What's our benefit? We have to know. We have to get answer for the questions. Then we understand the greatest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in Surah Al-Fajr: وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرٍ. Swearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as all of you know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear, it's something after that. It's a warning from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when He swears subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swear by whatever He created subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He started subhanahu wa ta'ala by Al-Fajr. And Al-Fajr, as we know, it's the end time of the night and the beginning of the day. You sleep the whole night and you wake up at the Fajr time. The light will be everywhere after the Fajr. You start your day, you start to go to your work, you start earning money, and the light not only for you, mankind, for everything in the earth. For the ocean, for the mountain, for the plant, for the animal, for you, for everything in the earth. It's a great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu swear by Al-Fajr. But the first thing you have to do it, when you hear this word, what Al-Fajr, when you are awake, first thing you do to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you run to the masjid to pray Al-Fajr. You say, thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this time. He let me awake after long time sleep, I don't know if I will be awake again or not. So first thing you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by you come to the masjid and you pray your fajr. It's a time. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ 10 days, 10 nights. These 10 nights, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it, إِنَّهَا أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالُ إِلَى اللَّهُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ The best deeds, the good deeds you do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves it most in these days. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, وَلَى الْجِهَادِ And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَى الْجِهَادِ Not even the jihad. إِلَّا Except a man took his money, his wealth, and he went to the jihad في سبيل الله for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will never return back by himself and his money. That's the only condition. Imagine those days. The scholars, they have different opinions. And they said these 10 days, it's the 10 days after the 30 days Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to Kalimullah Musa when he spoke to Musa alayhi salam. And some they said it's the last 10 days of Shahr Ramadan because they have the night of Laylatul Qadr. And some they said it's the time of the 10 days of the Hajj because it has the day of Arafah. It's all opinions. But only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa ta'ala. But the most of them, they said this is the 10 days of the Hijjah. Because of the Hijjah came thus last part for us from the five pillars of the Islam. Shahadat la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, Iqam al-Salah, Itay al-Zakah, Sawm Ramadan, Hajj al-Bayt al-Man istata'a ilayhi sabila. And the Hajj is forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to wash all the sins for the people who went there to the Hajj. And the Hajj is Arafah. One day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed all the sins from this person. Clean it completely. But Allah swear by those days. So we have to know why those nights is very important for us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast most of those days, nine, as Hadith Aisha radiallahu anhu arda'ha, but she didn't confirm it because they said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave one night for one of each of his wife. So Aisha, this night she wasn't sure he fasted the 9 days or not, but Umm Hafsa, she said, yes, he was fasting the 9 days, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before he asked us to follow the Hajj, you know what he did for the Muslim people in the earth? You know what he asked Ibrahim alayhi salam before we come to this dunya? He said to Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam, "An tahhira baytiya, an tahhira baytiya, purify my house for my people. They will come." And he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, there's no one. What should I do? He said, وَأَذِّن وَأَذِّن فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيرٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, just call them. They will come to you. Very from everywhere in the earth. Different transportation, Ibrahim. Just to call. عَلَيْكَ النِّدَاءُ وَعَلَيْنَا الْبَلَاءُ You just to call them and I will let everyone know about the Hajj. Yes, Ya Allah. قَوْلُكَ الْحَقِّ Words of Allah's truth. Now not even many people cannot go because of the visa. It's limited. You cannot go because it's limited. If it's open, everyone will love to go there. And when he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَنْتَحِجُّ بَيْتُ اللَّهِ You have to go for the Hajj. It's a fard. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, every year. And he didn't answer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he repeated to him again, Ya Rasulullah, every year. And he didn't answer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, every year. And he said, once in your life. Imagine if he said yes. Imagine if he said yes. It would be a war every year to go for the Hajj. But But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He asked Ibrahim to beautify his house for the Hajjaj to come and pray over there, Ibrahim, he was wondering, but we wondering more when we go over there and you do the Hajj and you do the Tawaf and you see the Safa and Marwa and you wondering with soft and over there you can run easy and simple and you get tired. While your mother, she was running back and forth looking for the water for Ismail alayhi salam. She never got tired. Because Ibrahim left them in the desert. When she called him, oh Ibrahim, أَمَرَكَ اللَّهِ, did Allah ask it you? He said, yes. He said, وَاللَّهِ فَلَنْ يُضَيِّعْنَا أَبَدًا. He will never forget us. And she was running between Safa and Marwa until Jibreel alayhi salam, by his wing, he dropped the earth and the water came under Ismail alayhi salam, and she started to hold the water. Zim, 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 the water. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was laughing when he say, Rahim Allah Ummu Ismail. Allah make rahmah for Ummu Ismail. Law lam tu zim, zim, if she didn't zim, 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 the zamzam water will run as a river for all the Arab country. Rahim Allah Ummu Ismail. We go for the Hajj. Al-Hajj, forgiveness from the sins. You come back, you come back the same day you just come from this dunya. But why this 10 days again? Listen to Sayyidina Umar and Abdullah ibn Umar and the Ashab Rasulullah. When these days started, they go to the market, they go everywhere, and they raise Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. The companion said, if they did it in the masjid, the whole masjid shaking. As you see, high waves in the ocean when they do the takbir. This ashab Rasulullah, this greatest day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love it. Zikrullah azza wa jal. Increase zikrullah azza wa jal. Alhamdulillah, the days is not started yet. To help all of us to understand what is the meaning of these 10 diets. If you have the niyyah to do the dhabiha, you cannot remove any of your hair or your nail. Only the person who will pay for the dhabiha. You make the niyyah from the beginning of the 10 days. You will do slaughter, a qurbani. But listen to Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu arda. He sent one from the Sahaba to Al-Ansar, and he said, go over there, look at the people who will be able to go for the Hajj, and they didn't do it, get the rubber and beat them up. Imagine how important the Hajj is. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, alaykum bil hajj. What about the qurban, ya Rasulullah? And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everyone, he has money to do the qurban, and he's not doing it, fala yaqrabu sallana. He don't let him come and pray with us. He's not among us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it, at'imu al-ba'is al-faqir, feed the poor and need. That's how is the mercy of the Islam. Al-hajj. Listen to Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, when he said, if you have the ability to do the Hajj and they didn't do it, فَمُوتَ عَلَى النَّصْرَانِيَّ أَوْ الْيَهُودِيَّ, so you can die as a Christian or Jew if you have the money and you don't go for the Hajj. But my dear brothers and sisters, in these 10 days, first of all, we have to come clear front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by your heart and your tongue, and you clear shahadat la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you don't do any sins anymore. Get closer to your family. Forgive everyone. Start fast these days. Don't give up, especially the day of Arafah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it. يغفر سنة ما قبلها وسنة ما بعدها. I get forgiveness 2 years, one before, one after. Gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you. Why you gonna waste it? Increase your salah, your nawafil, qiyam al-layl. Increase your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Visit the sick people. Spend money for the poor and need. Go for the sadaqah al-jariyah. The good deeds in this day, the best deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In distant days, as you do work, your brothers and sisters over there, they do the tawaf. They raise la ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. They raise it day and night, everywhere they go. Not the people who go for shopping. The people who is going for real, the Hajj, to see Maqam Ibrahim. And the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is truth. قُلْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ. See how it starts. Say صَدَقَ اللَّهُ, the word of Allah, truth. قُلْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ فَاتَّبِعُوا مِنَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِعَ لِلنَّاسِ لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ فِيهِمَ فِيهِ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ مَقَامُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مَنْ دَخَلَهُ كَانَ آمِنًا وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حَجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. The first house Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in the earth, لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّ مُبَارَكًا. And he said, the ulama, Bakka, the meaning of the word in Arabic language is the crowded place, which is Mecca. Allah said it in the Quran 1,000 years ago. Now we can see it. بِبَكَّ means a crowded place. Well, what is there? مقام إبراهيم, the place of Ibrahim. This is the first house Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it in the earth. And anyone enter this place, he's saved. It's the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حَجِّ الْبَيْتِ. Allah give you the order to do the Hajj. لِمَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. If you can. But if you cannot, you don't do it. You don't do it. So the Hajj is very important for all of us. This is the fifth pillar of the Islam. It's a fard for every one of us. But in Ramadan time, we come closer to the masajid. We come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray day and night. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in the end, we don't know if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it from us or not. But the Hajj, it's the call from whom? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gave me the order to come to his place to see the first house. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, this is the first house Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it in the earth. He said, Naam, لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّ مُبَارَكًا. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, and what is second? And they said, Baytul Maqdis, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save it. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, how far between? And they said, between them is 40 years. 40 years between the house of Allah and Baytul Maqdis. My dear brothers and sisters, in these days and these nights, before it started, you have to make the niyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be the great Muslim, the one who can extend the hand of to his brother to help the Muslim people, to help the poor and need. Imagine every one of us slaughter one qurban. How many people would eat from that? You don't slaughter it for yourself. You take third, and your neighbor, and the poor and need. You feed everyone, every single person of us. If he feed the poor and need, والله الذي لا إله إلا هو will never see any poor and need in the earth. This is the deen of Allah عز وجل. We have to say Alhamdulillah رب العالمين that he let all of us became a Muslim. Alhamdulillah. اذكروا الله العلي كثيرا
and remind the words of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar in the market, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, imagine this Qurbani, the one you slaughter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the order to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam to slaughter his son. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعْيَ قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنْ يَأْذُبُ ماذا ترى؟ When he grew as a man and he started to help his father Ibrahim عليه السلام, man, and he said, oh son, and see the mercy and love I saw in my dreams, I'm slaughtering you. And he said, يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر. Do whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you to do it, because رؤيا الأنبياء حق. The dream of the prophets true. Ya abati if'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'Allah min as-sabirin. Go ahead, fast, quick. Do it. Allah asked you. And when he starts slaughter Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, and he put his face toward the Qibla, Jibreel alayhi salam came down, bikabshin azim, wa fadaynahu bi dhibhin azim. The great chief, he came down from the sky to save Ismail alayhi salam. Now stop here and listen. If Ibrahim alayhi salam slaughtered his son Ismail, it will be our rules in our life. You will never see any males in the earth, because everyone will slaughter his son. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved all of us. Because he said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لَمْ يَلَاغَ اللَّهَ لُحُومِهَا وَلَا جِمَعِهَا. Allah will never eat this meat with the blood. But يَنَالُ وَالْتَقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. He need the taqwa from you. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the blood of Ismail alayhi salam, so we get saved. Or he would be stingy to slaughter one sheep for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would be stingy to feed the poor and needs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the rizq, and you don't want to spend from this rizq? Are you waiting until you go inside the grave? Yes, we all get the GPS to know where is the closest bank. Yes, we do have it to see the direction, except one direction, where you will be buried. No GPS. You cannot text anyone to put you anywhere. It will be over. Yes, your grave and your janaza can be in the Facebook. Yes, but you cannot see it. Are you waiting for this moment? Are you waiting for the moment when you be carried by someone while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you 10 nights, 10 great nights, 9 days fasting, and the day of Arafah most important, and you ignore it? We have to say alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us today before we start the 10 days. Make the niyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fast those days, my dear brothers and sisters. Make the niyyah for the qurbani, and remember, if you pay for the qurbani, don't remove any hair or nail. The person who paid the money cannot do that, because you share the hajish. You and the hajj at the same level. So the one who paid the money cannot remove a hair, or he cannot cut the niyyah. Only the one who paid the money. And make the niyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to visit the poor and need and feed them. Make the niyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get closer to your family. If you're not talking to anyone, please get the phone and call this person. You get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, this is the best time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the deeds himself and the good deeds from all of you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the hajj from our brothers and sisters until we get back home safe. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to save the blood of the Muslim people in the whole entire earth. أسك سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا أن يكفر عنا سيئاتنا وأن يشفي مرضانا وأن يرحم أمواتنا وأن يتقبل منا ويقبلنا ويغفر لنا ويرحمنا. نسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا بالقرآن وأن يدخلنا قبورنا بشفاعة القرآن ونلقاه بشفاعة القرآن ويدخلنا جناته جنات النعيم ونعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من النار التي لا نقدر عليها. نسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لوالدينا وأن يرحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لهم ذنوبهم، اللهم ارحمهم، اللهم استر عوراتنا وعورات نسائنا وبناتنا وأمهاتنا وأخواتنا يا كريم. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم. وأقم الصلاة.